Hello, I'm Lesley Logan, and today we're going to talk about the 100 on the mat, but we're also going to go over some information around the 100, and if you stay to the end, I'm going to give you some modifications to take your 100 down a notch, and even some tips on how to take it up a notch. All right? So the 100 on the mat probably is not your favorite exercise. However, it's one of my favorite exercises. Side little story. This is the exercise that I did first when I went to a Pilates class, and I fell freaking in love with Pilates because I literally felt all the connections that I wasn't finding on a run or at the gym. And so I really do love this exercise. It also is like the important exercise to warm you up for your whole Pilates practice. So let's break it down. I'm going to show you how it's ideally done, and then we'll talk about ways to take it, modify it, and then also take it up a notch. So the 100 is lying on your back, legs tight together, squeezing your heels. You're not in a huge turnout, so keep yourself in just a slight turnout. And then ideally you start with your arms back overhead, but you don't want your ribs popping out. So how can you find that happy spot where your arms are reaching from where they connect to your back without taking control of your lower ribs, upper abs? Take a deep breath in and then exhale. Lift your head, chest, and legs at the same time. That's key. Okay, so this is the ideal way to get in the 100, and then you pump your arms vigorously, and you can take your legs as high as you need, because every day is different. So today this is actually feeling a little bit better, but typically I can do my 100 on the mat right about here, right? So you find the spot where your legs actually feed into your center, and you wanna make sure you're checking in every single day, right? And so you should feel a lot of outer hips hugging in, a lot of inner thighs, getting the longest length in your spine for your flexion. And to get out of it, you do the exact same thing. You just lower the legs, lift the arms, and you would go right into the roll up, which is the next exercise in the sequence. But let's talk about how you can modify this and also advance this. So one modification would be to just leave the legs down. Lift your head and chest up, pump your arms. This is actually how Joseph Pilates would teach this exercise, and then one day you would just float your legs up. If you are struggling with other exercises like teaser two, double straight leg stretch, hip circles, if you're not able to lift your legs off of the mat, that's probably why. Another option would be to, you could actually just pump with your arms down and your head and chest down. This is hard work as it is, okay? So those are some options. Something that I like to have people do is pull their knees into their chest and then pump with their knees pulling in. So this is not a tabletop. I'm not a fan of the tabletop. We can talk about that another day. But I like to pull the knees into the chest, and that allows you to really feel your lower abs turn on, which is kind of the elusive part. And then you can send the legs out. So I know there's a lot of schools of thought of doing the 100 where you pull your knees in, lift your head and chest, and send the legs out. However, that's never going to prepare you for things like overhead, where you actually have to take your legs from the ground to go over. So it's better if you actually use the 100 to prepare you for the whole mat. And if that means right now you're here with your legs down, do that, right? So ways to advance it would be from the modification of legs straight down and then lifting the head and chest up at the same time. Another way to advance it is to try to get yourself to where your legs are just 2 inches off of the floor or in line with your eyes. So those would be the ways to advance it. And bigger pumps. So those pumps are meant to destabilize your center on purpose, right? Because our arms and our legs are actually part of what's called our axial skeleton. Sorry, our appendicular skeleton. Whoops. Your axial skeleton, hello, axis, is your tailbone to the crown of your head. So all the muscles that support that axial skeleton, that's your center. And if you're pumping your arms and you have your legs out distal, those are trying to take you out of your center. And so that's what is so cool about the 100 is that first exercise really tells you where you're tight, where you're loose, where you're connected, where you're not. And it really sets you up for the whole series you're about to do. If you are doing this exercise from my flashcard deck, woo! If you aren't, just know that we do have a deck of cards that has every single mat exercise. It has tips on each exercise, also some modifications and how to transition to the next exercise. So I would love for you to check that out. You can get it at onlinepilatesclasses.com. Also, if you're wanting to feel this exercise in a whole series, then definitely check out onlinepilatesclasses.com, because every single week we have a new 30-minute workout on your mat designed to help you do life better. I'll see you next time.